Can we be honest for a moment? Most of us aren't doing everything we know that we should do to create the best life for us and our families. Things like adequate rest, staying hydrated, exercising. Yes, of course, we have to talk about your diet. We understand that you have a lot going on between your spouse, your kids, work, church. I get it, right? So it makes sense to eat out. That requires less of you. But what else can you be doing under your current circumstances to better take care of you and your loved ones? Listen, one of the simple things that we do is take Organifi. Organifi is a line of organic superfood blends that offer plant-based nutrition with high-quality ingredients and less than 3 grams of sugar. Each superfood blend is easy to use by simply mixing it with water or your favorite beverage while on the go, providing you with quality nutrition throughout your day. Whether you're trying to lose weight, detox, improve your fitness, deal with stress or hormonal imbalances, Organifi is the answer. If we've learned anything in the last few years, it's that stress and anxiety can cause a lot of harm to us both mentally and physically. And that's because cortisol, the primary stress hormone, is supposed to spike when we're in danger. But get this, in the modern world, our cortisol is spiking all day long. Ashwagandha, the main ingredient in Organifi green juice, has been shown in multiple studies to reduce cortisol and stress. This delicious drink also features 10 other superfood ingredients, including moringa, chlorella, and spirulina, which works synergistically in the body to promote natural detoxing, more energy, and even healthy weight management through reducing cravings. It's amazing what the body is capable of with the right fuel. Plus, it's 100% certified organic, non-GMO, and tastes absolutely delicious. With their new apple crisp flavor, it's so easy to support your stress levels while enjoying a delicious morning green juice. If you're like me, guys, you know the importance of eating healthy, but you don't always have the time or willpower to cook with all the colors of the rainbow. Organifi Superfood, listen, the red, the gold juices, the Organifi Pure, Protein Powder, Organifi Glow, all these blends make it easy and enjoyable to add more variety and nutrition to your day. Just go to Organifi.com, that's Organifi.com/success to save 20% on your order.
It's time for you to make you a priority. And a lot of y'all, just to be honest, you can't build your own table. You can't make the kind of money you want to make. You can't do what you want to do because you don't understand you owe you first, right? And so we're going to walk you through 7 straight days. I know it say 5, but it's a pre-party. It's a post-party, all right? So we're going to walk you through how to, like literally, how to do for you, how to do for your family, whatever that means. When you want to do it, how you want to do it. Like, we're going to show you how to live life on your own terms. So I told you this before. Look, I gave you the secret to success. Now we're going to give you
the systems to success. Yeah. All right. Listen, never in a million years did I think that we would be living this kind of life. Never in a million years did I think we would now have the system to teach others. That's the thing I think. Somebody asked me what I was most proud of and what we've built. It's not just the fact that we've been able to live our dream life, but we've helped so many others. So we'll see you at the UOU Summit. We want to help you do the exact same thing. Go to UOUSummit.com and check us out. You ready?
I'm just being real. Everything you're fearing, is you actually are creating it by fearing it. You making up, like, I feel this is gonna happen, and your fear is actually, you start making fear decisions, and those fear decisions actually did. Now you going, look, I told you that was gonna happen. You created it with your fear. You made, and like, you gotta understand how powerful you are, because you thought the worst was gonna happen, the worst happened. You created it, you made it happen.
You ready?
Middle class is the only people who want something and don't have what they want. That's the only class. The wealthy have what they want. The poor don't want nothing more. It's the middle class that's struggling. It's the middle class. Because you've allowed what you didn't have, now that you have, to become your God, and you scared to lose it. You scared to lose it. Ain't nobody else afraid. Wealthy people ain't afraid. They'll put everything up because they know they can get it back. Broke people good because the first and 15th coming. Man, I used to love the first and 15th at my grandma and my aunties. We ate good. I'm talking about we ran through them food stamps quick. Wasn't nobody rationing. Wasn't nobody on. We ain't getting the next one for 2 weeks. It was like a celebration on the first. I'm talking about it was a celebration that you didn't get in middle class, because middle class was always saving for later. Middle class wasn't ever spending because they were scared. I'm talking about in the projects, we went for broke. They was getting ribs. I'm talking about stuff we ain't never had. We was getting it.
We back.
I'm just saying, the middle class is the only class. So I'm going to tell y'all, most of you in this room, why you're struggling. You are literally afraid to lose what you have. And so you will never risk talking to your spouse and having that real conversation. Because you like, if I had that real conversation, it might interrupt whatever intimacy means to you. So for you, intimacy could be y'all communicating greatly, y'all going, visiting, doing stuff. For him, it could be like sexual, right? And everybody's scared to say something, because everybody's scared to give up that 70% of success they have. That's the real truth. I don't have no struggles with poor people. They don't never require me or nothing. The wealthy don't require. Let me tell y'all something. Is Brandon here? Brandon's not here. Let me say this to y'all. When I do a gig that's $200,000, it's the least requirements.
Yeah.
They don't want nothing. They don't ask for pictures. They don't want nothing. 200 grand, they wealthy. They understand time. Come do your thing, get out of here. The least somebody paid me $5,000, they want a morning. I'm not, you think I'm playing. Ma, look at this. I can't make this stuff up. Ma, I can't make this up, Ma. This is a church. Ma, this is a church. This man want me to do a week of prayer. Tell me how much he said he was going to give me for the week.
1,000 for the week.
I can't make this up.
He got stipulations.
And they got stipulations. I can't make this stuff up.
2008 price.
I can't make this stuff up.
If you're willing to speak at night, an additional $1,000 to $1,500. $50 per day for food.
Come on. Oh, no, that's good. No. 50,
just,
you can
I'm
do something
saying.
With that 50.
I'm not
mad at the food stipend.
Hey, read that part. What'd he say? Right there.
I'm just the messenger. Don't shoot me. I told them how busy you are.
I'm just saying, watch this. You think I'm playing?
Thousand.
A week.
A week.
A week. $1,000 for a week. You about to put me to work.
Wait, include the 50. You got to include
habit
the 50.
Stack.
Habit stacking.
Bruh,
habit stacking. So I want y'all to know I'm telling you the truth. So if I could, if I just want to talk to my people in the room, I just want you to hear what I'm saying. It's not that you can't get to the next level. You are literally worshiping your plateau. Can I say this to you? You are literally worshiping the worst part of your life that you ever going to be at. You actually worship in the worst part of your life that you're going to be at. Look, I'm just being honest with y'all. As I sit here, I say this with confidence in the Lord. Today is the brokest I'll ever be.
Come on.
I say that with
Yeah, y'all should have felt that a little bit more than that.
I'm just being real.
Yeah, give it up for that.
This is the brokest I will ever be. And I'm not broke. This is the brokest I'll ever be. This is the least amount of celebrity I'll ever have is today. A month from today, I'm on the other side. We was at the restaurant. It was people in there at the restaurant staring. I didn't want to disrupt you, but one lady was like, "My husband's soft. He want a picture though. Can my man get a picture?" I was about 5-6 people over there. And guess what? None of them were. Huh? Yep. And none of them were. Come on, keep going. None of them was black. There was nobody black on that other side. Nobody was over there black. Everybody over there still knew. I was just listening to you 30 seconds. Is this you? It was 30 seconds. I just was listening to your video. I can't believe. Is that Didi? Oh, that's Jay. That's Jalen. That's the one in sports and spending all that money. I said, that's him. There you go right there. He like, Jay like, what's up? I was like, you don't know Jada, but that's my daughter. She incognito, but that's her right there. Jada was like, how you doing? From a distance, Jada was like, how you doing? So I'm just saying, you can be whatever you want to be, do whatever you want to do, but honestly, you are so afraid of your spouse, you ain't going to say nothing to them. You're so scared of your kids that you ain't going to say nothing to them. You're so afraid of that job, you ain't going to say nothing to them. You know they ain't treating you right, but you scared that they gonna pull it up on the rug up under you and you ain't gonna have nothing. And you know what? Because you think that, you are absolutely right. You 1,000% telling the truth. Here's what I want you to look at. I want you to look at how merciful God is. Even in your boogeyman gonna get you, look at how much he's blessed you. Even with the boogeyman mentality that you have, look how much he's blessed you. Imagine if you get rid of the boogeyman syndrome and really trust that he got your back. I'm telling you, you're gonna do it. So I'll just say it one more time, because it's hard. Some of y'all right now, it hurts. I feel you. It hurts. Man, I wanna say that to my spouse. I wanna tell her, but man, I wanna tell my wife. I'm gonna tell you. Me and Didi talked more 2 weeks ago than we've ever talked before. And Didi was like, yo, we turned the corner. Bruh, we both said it. God's been blessing us, but we was blessed on the same street. We've been going up and down that same blessed street. And God was like, son, you've been stuck on exceedingly abundantly. You've been stuck on Abundant Boulevard. Mm-hmm. Come on to Beyond now. Hit the corner. Just make a right, and you're going to be on Beyond. You know what I'm saying? You already own exceedingly abundant, whatever y'all are. God said, hit the corner. We had a heart. We had a tough conversation, and it was so tough, and it took about a week. That's how tough it was. We had to keep saying it for about 7 days. But we both, when we got hit the corner, was like, why did we stay on that street that long? Come on. It was good to us, but why was we on that street? And we was on that street because that street felt so good. It was so much of a blessing. But bro, we in abundant now. We ain't even gotta get dressed and go nowhere now. You hear what I'm being real. We don't gotta go out. We don't gotta spend no money. We don't have to do nothing. We've gotten to a place where our own company is a blessing to us. We don't need nothing extra. Not saying that we won't do it, but we don't need nothing extra. So stop being afraid to have that conversation. Live like the poor live and live like the rich live.
Didi, I need one at least head acknowledgement that we're getting the truth. You know what I'm saying? I ain't see.
Diddy said they ain't ready for her.
Yeah, come on.
Diddy said they ain't ready
for her. Go ahead, yeah.
Now, I was just going to ask the question. Like, who told y'all that being uncomfortable was a bad thing? Mm.
Your feelings?
I mean, when you really think about it, who told you that being uncomfortable is a bad thing? Like, everything that I do, I look for the uncomfortable in it. Because I understand that being uncomfortable is the only place where growth takes place. Mm. You think the caterpillar is comfortable when he's transforming into a butterfly? I mean, just think about it. Anything, when I'm working out, the only time that you get progress in your body is that. When you are uncomfortable, when your body hurts, when your muscles are sore. The reason why is because there's a pruning that's taking place. There's a tear down. Literally, when you work out, you're tearing your muscles. What you're doing, you're tearing them so that they can grow, they can expand, they can get tighter. But a lot of you all think that being comfortable, that's the goal in life for a lot of people. I'm just trying to be comfortable. I'm trying to be uncomfortable. Because I understand when I'm uncomfortable in my marriage, then that's only the point where me and my spouse, now we got some things to work out. When I'm uncomfortable in the gym, that means that there's something taking place in my body, right? Stretching, man, stretch. I didn't even realize how stretching is.
Bro, that's a whole nother science.
Oh, bro, like stretching is uncomfortable. I mean, just, you know, it's uncomfortable, but what's happening is it's necessary so that all your ligaments and everything is, you know, it's getting stretched. It's getting, you know, stretched so that you can be flexible. So stop looking, like literally change your whole mindset. Stop trying to become comfortable in things. Building a skyscraper is the most uncomfortable thing that I've ever been through. Sitting in this meeting in these rooms, And they using all of this wordage and I've never heard of, and I'm sitting here, man, and you know, even when we was with the lenders and we talking money, I never talked $61 million. That's a whole nother conversation when you're talking about money like that. It's uncomfortable. But just think about the result of it. So you guys got to start looking at, if you're uncomfortable with the act, then at least be comfortable with the vision. At least be comfortable with the vision, because if you're uncomfortable with the act of what you're doing, if you're uncomfortable working out all the time, be comfortable with the vision of how you're going to look once you realize your goal. If you're uncomfortable with starting a business, then at least be comfortable with the vision of what this business is going to do for you and your family once you realize it. So be comfortable with the vision, the end goal in mind. That's what you're supposed to be comfortable with. But the process is going to be uncomfortable. So get used to being uncomfortable, because that's the goal. That's the gift. That's what you want to do, because that's when something is going to move in your life. The needle is never going to move with you just sitting there being comfortable.
Can I say this too? The thing that you fear is the thing that's going to happen. Yeah. I'm just being real. The thing that you fear, like why you protecting what you protecting, why you saying what you saying, like that's going to actually create the very, I did a sermon maybe about two weeks ago. And you know, how many of you guys have ever heard about Job before? You ever heard about Job and what Job went through, right? Now, it was some crazy stuff that he went through. I mean, crazy. But if you read the scripture, he said that the thing that I greatly feared has come upon me. That's what he said. He didn't say I was shocked. I lost my son and my daughter. I lost all my stuff. This is shocking. He said it twice. This thing that I thought was going to happen to me, it happened to me. And it happened to me in great. I'm telling you, I'm just being real. Everything you're fearing, is you actually are creating it by fearing it. You making up, like, I feel this is going to happen. And your fear is actually, you start making fear decisions. And those fear decisions actually did. Now you're going, look, I told you that was going to happen. You created it with your fear. You made, and like, you got to understand how powerful you are. Because you thought the worst was going to happen, the worst happened. You created it. You made it happen. I can't believe, that's why I said, I don't do that. How much does the gas cost? Somebody asked me right there, how much was gas? I was like, does it matter? Do I not get to use it? Because like, do I not get to, like, it's, if it's a dollar a gallon, do I use it if it's $7 a gallon? Do I not use it? What difference does it make how much it costs? That's negative when you go, I can't believe the gas is $5 a gallon. What can you do about it? You're going to stop visiting? You're going to stop going places? Absolutely not. So why would I concern myself? That's fear-based. Oh, you just bought a house in California. You know you could lose the house. You know you could die too. You know you could die tomorrow, don't you? Something bad can happen to all of us. So I'm not focused on if I'm going to lose it. I'm focused on I have it right now. Why are you even thinking about losing it? Let's focus on we in it. Let's enjoy it. Right? Does that make sense? And so I'm trying to tell you, you're really hurting yourself being on the fear side, because the fear side only creates death. All it ever produces was death, separation, destruction. So I would get on the other side and I would just start saying positive stuff. Like, I don't care how much the gas costs. God will make me enough money where I don't even have to worry about how much gas is. I don't care. Man, I told y'all, people all the time, California, it's just too expensive. I'm like, they've got probably more people between California and Texas. There's more people that live in California and Texas than anywhere else in the world. A bunch of millions of people are in California. If it was that expensive, nobody would live there. Somebody else can afford it. So if they can afford it, I can afford it. I just need y'all to listen to me, please. Get on the side. Think on the side that's going to move the needle in your life. Think on that side. If you have two sides, and the negative side has not gotten you to where you want to be, man, start doing the other side. It's not rocket science.
But E, let me say this, and please jump in. Here's the craziest thing about getting on the other side, and I honestly feel like I've been on both sides. I was raised middle class.
No question.
And I remember I told you I'm gonna write the book, All My Friends Are Rich, right? And it's the truth, and it's weird, and it sounds weird. Like, there's no way all your friends are rich. They really are. But as I'm thinking about this thing, E, once you cross over to that side and that mindset, like, everything gets easier.
It's way easier.
That's the crazy thing about it. It's like, when you live in that lack and that fear and all of that, and you like doing all of that stuff, it's always like a constant, bro, I promise you get on this side, it's just like, oh, who wanna go out to eat and just not pay for nothing with a $5,000 bill, and people like, oh, it's just comped. You start getting into a place where people start looking at you and just going, here, they call Maul. Oh, Maul called me all the time now. And just because he's Maul, people, oh yeah, dude called me up. Yeah, they told me this deal ain't on the market, but we just bought a property, $600,000. We got it for $250. You'd be like, what? Like, shouldn't that go to the person who?
Who's poor, yes.
I'm saying, yeah. Why Maul getting a $600,000 building for $250?
Come on, straight up.
How come? It don't make sense, but I'm just telling you, once you get on the other side, it's like, yo, it's all of this starts to open up to you. And that's the scary part about staying down there is it's like, it's a constant fight of like these limited resources. But when you come to the other side, it's literally like you walk in and it's like, yo, people just start handing stuff to you. I'm just saying, because you're operating with other individuals who don't see anything as lack. They don't see any lack. Does that make sense? Like, and I promise you, it's not fair. I was like, yo, we used to be at the office, Carl, making peanut butter and jellies, walking to the store because it was expensive for us to eat out every day. And when we ran out of calf tickets. They only gave us like 2-3 for the week.
Yeah.
We there for 5-6 days. So we would go to the store and buy like these pastrami sandwiches. We walked to the store. Every once in a while when we had like a half day or something, we go to Eat Crib and you put that joint on the stove and on the frying pan.
When Didi was at work. Yeah.
Do you know, I'm talking about we couldn't get a Chipotle gift card back then. Bruh, we walking in places now, I'm talking about we done ordered for the whole church.
Straight up.
And then got the bill, and it say zero. And we like, yeah, y'all made a mistake with the bill. They like, no, E.T. changed my life. Y'all good, get out of here. Mm. I'm like, where was that? We actually can pay now.
Right, we don't need it. We don't need it.
Now. Like, yo, where was this energy?
Right.
But it don't, so please.
I'm just saying it's frequency.
Mm-hmm.
It's frequency.
Yeah, yeah.
No, I'm just being real. Carl, can you break that down? Because I used to get pissed at Carl, like, bruh, I hate mics, y'all. And so I would have my own mic, and I'd be doing. Carl would give me this device to go anytime I would go somewhere. It's a Zoom device, a Zoom device, and it was like I would cut it on, and I come back, and Carl would be like, "E, we didn't get the record." And I'm like, "Carl, what do you mean? I pushed the button, bruh. I had the mic on. I pushed the button." He was like, "No, the frequency." So can you explain? What that is.
So again, microphones, everything that we use operates on a frequency, mostly electrical frequency, right? So with the reference to the microphones, these mics that we're using, each mic has its own little number. I'll break it real simple. Little number that there's a receiver back there that it corresponds to. So the information coming from this mic goes to the corresponding receiver. Anything else in the room has frequencies and can potentially interfere with any other frequency. So, like, again, I'm talking tech, but I want you guys to hear it. There's frequencies all around. LED lights, there's all kinds of frequencies. So what, and E, I don't know if I didn't do a good enough job explaining it to you.
You probably did. I wasn't paying attention.
But the real process is when you're going to a new environment, you scan for open frequencies. And that microphone and receiver is like, oh, this range is open from 525 whatever to 560 whatever. That frequency is open, no interference. You can hear me clearly because there's no interference in my microphone right now. If we were to switch frequencies and put these two on the same frequency, it'll be chaos in here. Screeching, it has to be on the right frequency where nothing else is for the message to be clear.
So what was happening with my mic where it wasn't picking up, or it was, they would always be like, you messing up our stuff. What was that all about?
So again, it'll cause static. Your mic going into their environment is already set. They already have a set range of frequencies for these microphones. So you bring yours in sometimes and you don't scan a frequency. You could be on somebody else's frequency.
So here's what happens. When you come into a room with fear, you pick up everybody. Everybody who afraid pick up each other's frequencies. Everybody who fearful, they pick up. Everybody in the room who lack, y'all pick up each other's frequency. Everybody who you ain't got nothing but time to talk about other people instead of your own dreams and goals, y'all pick up each other's frequencies. People who rich and trying to make money, they walk in the room and they all pick up each other's frequencies. It's frequencies. That's what I'm trying to tell you. So, yeah, there is a frequency. How much gas costs? There is a frequency for that. How much gas costs? And everybody talking about it. How much gas costs? How many? 4 pounds of meat is four. I can't. The bread cost. Somebody told me the other day. This blew my mind. I never thought I would hear this. Somebody was like, I ain't buy eggs. I said, why not? Eggs way too expensive. I said, eggs expensive? They said, yeah, eggs is. They told me, I think it was like $2-3 a carton or something like that. I promise you I don't know how much no eggs cost. I've never eggs. I just go get them. You know what I'm saying? I just go get 18 of them. I eat a lot of eggs. Bread. Did you know that the bread went up? I was like, it did? When did it go up? I didn't get the memo. You think I'm playing. Somebody always calling me. You didn't hear that in the news. You didn't hear that. Nobody here. Why? The free. You know marriage is terrible. I wouldn't even get married if I was you. Marriages don't ever work out. I'm like, they don't? They don't?
Man, they for real. Don't? No, talk about that.
They don't?
Talk about
I'm
it.
I'm on a different frequency. I didn't know that they didn't work out. I didn't pick up that frequency.
Is hiring challenging? Yes. Do you love a challenge? Also yes. You need a hiring partner that can help you rise to the challenge. You need Indeed. Indeed is the hiring platform where you can attract, interview, and hire all in one place. Instead of spending hours on multiple job sites searching for candidates with the right skills, Indeed's a powerful hiring platform that can help you do it all. They streamline hiring with powerful tools that help you find matched candidates. With their Instant Match program, over 80% of employers get quality candidates whose resume on Indeed actually matches their job description, and it happens the moment they sponsor a job, according to Indeed Data US. And let me say that again in case you missed it, right? Indeed does all the hard work for you. They show you candidates whose resumes on Indeed fit your description immediately after you post, so you can hire faster. And even better than that, Indeed's the only job site where you can only pay for applications that meet your must-have requirements. According to Talent Nest 2019, Indeed is an unbelievably powerful hiring platform, delivering 4 times more hires than all the other job sites combined. Join more than 3 million businesses worldwide that use Indeed to hire great talent fast. Start hiring right now with a $75 sponsored job credit to upgrade your job post at Indeed.com/success. Offer is good for a limited time. Again, claim your $75 credit right now at Indeed.com/success. Indeed.com/success. Terms and conditions apply. Need to hire? You need Indeed.
Oh, that's it. Somebody take the mic. Take the mic.
The word says to think of whatever is true.
Yeah.
Whatever is lovely, whatever is noble, whatever is kind, whatever is pure. That's frequency. Right, so I think we go back to our thoughts and our brain, and when we really adopt that kingdom mindset and we realize we're citizens of the kingdom, there are certain rights and privileges that we have. It's a certain energy, a certain frequency that we operate with. So when I hear the word, and it doesn't say pure, lovely, it says true first. Think of whatever is true, because we will lie to ourselves. God revealed to me a few years ago, he said, Jeremy, you are a master manipulator. Like, in your brain, you come up with all these different scenarios that's not even true. God was like, why do you do that? You know what I'm saying? And so we got to think of whatever's true, whatever's lovely, whatever's kind, whatever's pure. Like, think of these things. And I think, like, that's the importance. Because, you know, we heard it, right? As a man thinketh, so is he. And so it really starts with our mindsets and the way that we think and
how?
The way that we process.
How? One of y'all take this. How? Because there are people in the room right now who like, yo, I'm ready to do that. But they're like, how? Now, I'm just going to say this, and people get mad at me all the time. You running. I'm not running. When I run into negative energy, I cut it off now. It's not a person. I ain't mad at nobody. The reason why I can't deal with a certain frequency is that frequency does not produce. There's nothing wrong with the person. That's not a producing frequency. We cannot produce in that frequency. We cannot get rich in that frequency. We cannot grow in that frequency. We can't do it. So I back off, because you like that, you stuck on that frequency. So that don't make you a bad person, but you stuck on that. So I'm good. Go for it. Like, look, I said something in church. Man, I ain't even want to say it. He made me say it. Listen to me. I'm going to stand up and say this. I'm a pastor, right? So when adults come to church, they have the ability to try to hide their frequency. They're adults, so they know how to push buttons and kind of fake it. But I said, shh, you got it twisted. You don't realize when your children come in, they don't know how to do that. So whatever conversations you've been having about me, when your babies show up, they show me your real frequency.
Come on.
When your child don't speak to me, it's something that's being said at the house that's not warming. So when they see me, they back off because they like, ah, something's being said. You can play it off because you're an adult. Your 9-year-old can't play it off. Your 12-year-old can't play it off. So there's a frequency that's happening in your home. And then when you walk out your home and you come into a different frequency, Carl said it, frequencies are everywhere. I'm not saying that it's a bad frequency. I'm saying it's just not a frequency that produces wealth. And so I back away from it. I'm not backing away from you. As soon as you get the wealth frequency, let's go. But when you don't have it, it's nothing against you. I just want to, I know I don't have a long time on earth, so I'm not into playing games. I want to get as much out of this earth that I can get out while I'm here. Does that make sense? So actually, I told y'all yesterday, I wasn't mad at my mom. I just said, hey, don't bring me that frequency because I need to stay in this frequency so I can make sure we all eating. I need to make sure we all taken care of. So when you come into this frequency, if you're not ready to be on this frequency, that's cool, but don't disrupt this frequency because this is the frequency that's going to make sure we eat. This is the frequency that's going to make sure anywhere I go, we go. Here's the, okay, CJ, yes, what's the one thing people say about when they come to our conference or they get involved in what we do outside of us, what shocks them about the people that we bring in?
Just how down to earth people are, how just good people.
Good people. They say to me, E, how in the world you had this dude call me, he didn't even try to take advantage of me sexually. This dude called me, gave me more call and just did. How does that happen? Like most places that we go to, E, they never try to take our money. They never try to, E, hot frequency. The frequency, the people that I attract are on what I'm on. And so I know when they go out, they're gonna go out. We all gonna go out representing Christ and we gonna do what God would do. And so my stuff is deeper because it's not who's on your team. Everybody in the NBA, everybody got the same roster. Everybody got a PT, everybody got a head coach, assistant coach. The Pistons don't look like the Lakers. Somebody told me in the playoffs, who you got in the playoffs? I said, I don't have the Lakers, but let me tell you this, don't count them out. Mm-hmm. Why? They got LeBron. That's a different frequency. Little man talking about something, he out of a job. He got fired. Not only did LeBron, he said to LeBron, bro, you ain't putting up 40. Not only did LeBron do what LeBron does, the last game, that team in the playoffs got beat by 40.
Exact number, though?
The exact number, frequency. You put 40 out there, LeBron put 40 back on you. You look like, y'all look like kids in the playoffs. They beat you by 40? Another basketball team in the playoffs? You know what the playoffs mean? The playoffs mean, what was it? They were ranked.
There was a two
seed. They were ranked number two.
Lakers were seven.
The Lakers were seven. But watch what happened with the Lakers. They had some injuries. People weren't playing. The last 10, 12 games, everybody got back on one accord.
Hold on, not just that. They made some trades and got rid of some scrubs.
Oh, I didn't want to.
Okay, I didn't want to go there.
I'm just saying.
They did have to get rid of some people and bring some new people on that fit the
frequency.
And so here's the good news for you. If you feel convicted by this convo and you like, man, I'm on the wrong frequency, you can always change it. Yeah. That's a good thing. Like when y'all go back home, you can make the decision, right? They can decide, I'm not going to be in this relationship no more. Or I'm not taking this person's phone call no more. Or I'm about to tap in with this person right here. Like you have an opportunity now to change the frequency that you on.
And how you can, do that again,
and,
Carl?
And you can switch it. It's like a little. It's some little tweaks. I know you're gonna break down. Let me give you a tangible example of how sometimes you gotta change the frequency throughout the day. I remember one time when my wife was working, she came home and she was stressed. She had an attitude. She was not in the spirit. And the flesh in me wanted to be like, man, don't put that on me. Like I ain't. Your boss said this. Like. I almost got on her frequency. Now, what happens, Carl, when two mics are on the same frequency? You get that static. And so God said, son, I need you to be strong enough, long enough for her to get this breakthrough. So he's like, just love on her.
Just, are you strong enough? You used to be gangster back in the day. How about you let her be her punching bag? She already not valued that's as a black gangster. Woman out here working for the government and corporate America anyway. Like, so how about you just be strong enough and just love on her and give her grace? She having a rough day. I had to change the frequency, because if I would have got on that frustrating frequency that she was on, it would have been static between us, and now the enemy's sitting back laughing. And I'm like, bro, I'm not Kevin Hart. I'm not somebody that's here to gag and Google with you. So I had to change my frequency. So Carl, maybe you can break that down on how
you're
they can switch over.
Carl.
And I want you guys to let me do this. Who needs a change of frequency? Let's just be real.
I'm trying to go to it.
This is step one. I thought everybody's hand was going to go up. I really thought so. Yeah. No, I'm not trying to shame nobody, but I honestly thought everybody's hand was going to go up, because we all got something that we got to work on, right? And I'll be 100%. Transparency frees you. I've had moments of frequency off, and I walked into your door one day, and we had probably like a 3-minute conversation. You remember?
I do.
I walked into E's house, and it wasn't this language, but my language to E was, bruh, my frequency is off as it relates to you. We got to be transparent. Like, don't, he just said it. You identify immediately, my wife off. So you know when something's off. You wake up and you know that you're not yourself right now. You know when something's off. Let's not play with that. Let's stop. I might be 15 minutes late to work today. I apologize, but I need to stop right now and identify what frequency I'm on. What's going on? What's the opposite of that frequency? Like, I'm not trying to be deep. What's the opposite of that? If it's fear, what's the opposite of that? If you don't know, I told you, go look at that emotion wheel. Like, there's some stuff it's funny, Maul. I found one as we were talking just now that said good emotions, bad emotions. Like, it breaks it down for you. So I want you to look at the opposite one. If this is what I'm feeling, this is that. Read the definitions of them. We all know you know the definitions of words for real, for real. Like, read the definition of what it means. When you're feeling this, break it all the way down and see, okay, this is, like I told you, mine is inadequate. What does that mean? I feel like others, listen to me carefully. I don't feel like I'm bad. I feel like other people are better. I'm understanding, I'm getting clarity. You see what I'm saying? So when somebody says you got low self-esteem, no, not quite. Like, I actually feel I'm good at what I do.
Right.
But I just see other people as better. There's a difference there. So if you don't understand the difference, then you got to spend time. That's what I'm saying. Once you identify the thing, now we got to spend some time. Oh, I understand it. Where did it come from? Let's get the root of this. What did my mom say? What did my brother say? And it could be something so stupid, Jeremy. I got a book coming out. It's in the book, but I'll give y'all the sneak peek. Mine was a high school girl. I'm just being simple. Not Karate Carl. Not that girl. Not that girl.
You want to kick? You want to kick?
But trying to be serious up here. But I'm just being real. One little circumstance, right? And I'm telling y'all, that's something that messed with my mind for a long time. I was going to say the rest of my life. That ain't the truth. I ain't speaking that. It messed with my mind for a long time. I can track it back. Oh, that's what happened. That's why I felt this. Now we got to start turning the dial the opposite direction, all right? So I need y'all for real, to understand where you are. That's the first step. If you need to make a change, please. Listen, anybody that I talk to in here, I'm not pretending no more. Like, yo, this is where I am.
So can I ask you a question?
Yeah.
Because I don't even think they heard what you said. You said it fast and you did it. I just want them to hear what you said.
Ground school don't have no energy, so yeah. I'm trying to be different.
I don't know if y'all caught it.
I'm trying to be different.
What Carl said was he literally came to my house.
Oh, literally.
Knocked on my door, came in the house and said what he said. He didn't say it like that, but he said, like, the way I'm feeling about you is not right. I'm not feeling right. He literally came to my house, I just want y'all to hear what he's saying, because it went by. I don't think most of y'all caught what he said. He knocked on the door, he came in. It wasn't a long conversation. I need prayer. As it relates to our relationship right now, I'm not in a good space. Does that make sense? So he acknowledged that. Carl, what was the difference then before, because you felt you could have felt like that 3 years ago and you wouldn't have said anything.
So
help people.
No, I'm just saying, I'm tired. I'm tired, y'all. I'm 43 years old. I'm right there with you. You look better, though. I'm tired, y'all. I ain't got time to play. Like, I don't have time to play. And again, all the stuff that I did got me here, but I ain't going no further. We just talked about it. Maul, you just talked about it. It's growth in the discomfort. Yeah.
So if I keep just chilling here, like I know I got this feeling, like it's real. And watch this. There's growth in that too. Yeah. That's growing. The other side is growing if you're not doing something against it. You see what I'm saying? The comfort in the foolishness is growing. And I'm just like, yo, I'm tired. Like I understand what healthy looks like. And I understand now, TJ Priest, I understand what unhealthy looks like.
That's right. That's right.
I'm clear. Like that again, this I'm talking about any person anywhere. You understand good and you understand bad. Like we ain't gotta play games right. no more. Right. So if I have this reaction when I'm relating to somebody that and listen to my language. E, hear me closely. I walked into his house. I was like, yo, honestly, I don't even need no response from you. Hear what I need to say to you, though. As it relates to our relationship, I'm not feeling what I used to feel. Now hear this. You have done nothing wrong. I want to be clear. You didn't do nothing. Bro, you've been here. You kept doing what you're doing. But in my heart, E, I don't feel right. I don't feel, Nikki, we always talk about warm and fuzzy. I don't feel warm and fuzzy right now.
Amen.
And there's no excuse. There's no explanation. No, I just need to be transparent and let this out in the air because if it doesn't get out, come on, y'all. We know it grows. Cancer grows.
And grow like a cancer.
It grows. And I'm like, I don't want that in me. I don't want to live my life uncomfortable. I want to walk out here proud. Quest was like, dude, you walk different. That's how I want to walk. I want to walk with my chest high. I ain't got no beef. I don't want to have no beef with nobody on planet Earth. It ain't worth my time. It ain't worth my time. Like, for what?
And can I ask you this, Carl?
What?
When you was, not this time, but before when you was on that frequency, like, man, E, I don't, and you didn't know how to say it, were there other people who felt your frequency and tried to?
He set me up, y'all.
I'm just being real.
100%, of course.
I'm just being real.
Of course.
So even when you own that, you ain't no by yourself.
No.
So once you go, man, I feel some type of way about E, but you don't say nothing to E, other people going to sense the frequency. And oh, he got something against E. Let me tell him, I feel some kind of way against E too. And try to pull him into coming on the dark side. Does that make sense? That's the other reason why you need to deal with your frequency. Because if you don't deal with it, there's some other people that's going to pull you. And the last thing, listen to me, I tell people this all the time. When it, in business, so people get it. I told y'all this the other day. When it comes to CJ and I, listen to me. You can't come talk bad to me about C. Because if you come and talking bad about him, I already know what your agenda is. And it ain't nobody, you ain't got nothing to say to me about him. Why are you even come talking to me about CJ? You must got some ill intentions in the first place. Go tell CJ what you saying. Why are you coming to me telling me, hey, E, you know CJ, bro, don't talk to me about CJ. The only person that gets to talk to me about CJ is CJ talking to me about CJ. I don't even get to have thoughts in my head about him. Only the facts. And I'm telling y'all, a lot of y'all, your frequency is off, and you are now entertaining other people whose frequency is off, and you're gonna find yourself in a very dark space, in a dark place, and some of you may not be able to get back. So do yourself a huge favor. If that ain't the side you really wanna be on, and it always start, man, you ever see Darth Vader? Star Wars, they always start on the right side. They always start on the right side in Star Wars. But something pulls them. You know what pulls them? They fear.
Fear.
That's what pulled them over there. They fear. Go watch it. Darth Vader wasn't no bad person. He was a good person that feared something was going to happen to his family. And that's exactly what happened. She actually died because he went over to the dark side. So I'm telling you, it's a lot of you, you're good people with good frequency, but you have a bad moment and you get on a bad frequency and then bad frequency be like, come over here. And now you living on the bad frequency. And most of y'all don't even want to be with the people you with on the bad frequency. It's just y'all got in common bad frequency. You don't necessarily like, you didn't dream of being with them. For real, they got bad frequency and they ain't going nowhere. And now you with them in their bad frequency. So I'm just saying, stop. You know where you want to be and you know what you want and you know what you want to do. Do what Carl did. And come and say it. And it was tough for me not to say something back because I wanted to be like, Carl, we're friends.
I can see him fighting too.
We're friends. I love you. God said, shut your mouth. He's doing what he's doing. And I don't know. It took a day. I don't know. It could have been later that evening. We was back on the right frequency because he acknowledged he wasn't on the right frequency.
You're listening to a podcast right now that was done in Mexico. Guess what, guys? We had to communicate with our AV team, our lighting team, our drivers. If you have an upcoming summer trip abroad, listen, my go-to travel hack is Babbel. Whether you're a seasoned traveler or embarking on your first adventure, communication is key to fully experiencing a new culture. And that's where Babbel comes in. Babbel is the language learning app that sold more than 10 million subscriptions. Thanks to Babbel's addictively fun and easy bite-sized language lessons, there's still time to learn a new language before you reach your destination. With Babbel, you only need 10 minutes to complete a lesson, so you can start having real-life conversations in as little as 3 weeks. Babbel's expertly crafted lessons are built around real life. You learn how to have practical conversations about travel, relationships, business, and more. So the competitors, right, other language learning apps, they use AI for their lesson plans, which is cool, but Babbel's lessons were created by over 150 language experts, and they're voiced by real native speakers and not computers. Their teaching method has been scientifically proven to be effective. With Babbel, you can choose from 14 different languages. Plus, Babbel's speech recognition technology helps you to improve your pronunciation and your accent. There's so many different ways you can learn with Babbel. In addition to the lessons, you can access podcasts, games, videos, stories, and even live classes. Plus, it comes with a 20-day money-back guarantee. Start your new language learning journey today with Babbel. Right now, get up to 55% off your subscription when you go to babbel.com/success. Again, that's babbel.com/success. And you can get up to 55% off your subscription. Babbel, language for life.
Hey, question. How many of y'all, y'all hearing them talk about frequencies? How many of y'all really believe that is a such thing as frequencies? Raise your hand.
Oh, I know it.
I just want to make sure because, you know, God created bees. Bees don't talk with their mouth, right? Hmm. They talk on a frequency. You got insects talking frequencies. And I feel like, you said bats?
I think so.
Oh, and then I feel like I'm you guys, right? These guys, I don't have the stories they had. I didn't know E 30 years. I wasn't on campus eating peanut butter and jelly sandwiches. You know, I was in the audience. I was literally sitting in this front row. Guaranteed, if I wouldn't be on the stage today, I would be in this front row right now. But it was something about the frequency that I was on that I was picking up sitting in this front row. I'm telling you, all this stuff is for real. Camille can tell you, well before I even met these guys, I would be listening to all of these videos. I would be listening. I was on a freak. I was tuning in.
Ooh.
I was tuning in, listening to all the videos. I never practiced being a motivational speaker. I never even looked to be a speaker, but I listened to this man so many times. The frequency started to change my dial, my tune. I remember when my sister, is Carly here? My sister was going through, this is well before, Carla, what year was that when you was diagnosed with breast cancer? 2016. I was sending you, what was I sending you every single morning? I told you because she was down and out, almost like she was like, oh, it was a death sentence. What was I sending you every single morning from the start to the finish? When was I sending, today told you that you was cancer free. What was I sending you every morning you woke up? That's Brian. You gotta be hungry.
So for the record, for the people listening, scriptures, ET videos, E.T. Les Brown videos.
Les Brown video. Okay, cool. I was doing this before I was the 9 to 5 millionaire. Mm. But the reason why I'm the 9 to 5 million is because of what I was doing. It's because of the frequency. What I'm telling y'all, they say it so fast and they just, but I'm sitting here telling y'all it's real. Like I'm y'all. These guys are something special. I wasn't behind the camera. You got to breathe better as you want to see. I wasn't there.
Now you keep saying it wrong. I'm going to let you say it wrong one more time.
The only reason why I say it wrong is because you spelt it wrong.
So right now.
I'm trying to make it feel good.
When I was a child, I spake as a child. I got that E on the end now.
But I'm saying that, and I always, you know, I'm always for the people because I'm from the people. You know, I wasn't like them. And so I want you guys to just know, like, man, it's a frequency that you guys got to tap into. And it's a frequency that a lot of you all are tapping into. I can name several of you all that's in this audience. Just keep tapping in. Keep tuning. Like, you remember on the radios back in the day? You too young, CJ. I'm talking to E. It's this grown side over
kiss,
here.
The kiss.
Right. Right. Remember that you kept on? You kept twisting and you kept hearing a little bit of hint of the music. You kept, as you kept tuning in, you would sometimes your parents had you hold an antenna or something. But you would, the more you kept turning, the more and more you would hear the song. You would hear the station that you were trying to tune into. So some of you all right now believe that you're not there. My message and my word to you is that just keep turning. Just keep turning. I promise, just keep turning. And you don't, I didn't know what station I was about to listen to. God knew. It's not my job, it's not your job to know what's tune gonna come from that station that you, your job is to keep turning though. And every day I kept turning. Every day I kept doing it. This is the end result of it. So now I'm in tune with these brothers and it, you know, it ain't going nowhere. But so I'm telling y'all, who knows what's on the other side of what you guys are tuning into. So keep on tuning into whatever God got for you.
Man,
so
if you want to tune in with us and our frequency, UOUSummit.com. That's what we call a segue in the business. You know what I'm saying? UOUSummit.com. Yeah, y'all can give it up for everybody up here. May 29th, UOUSummit.com. Tap in. It's going to be an incredible few days. We have an incredible lineup for you that we've never had, guests that we've never had. UOUSummit.com. Go there right now, and I'm going to just tell y'all, for y'all in attendance, y'all need to go ahead and be at the mastermind as well. The summit is going to be incredible. But we also have a corresponding mastermind that is going to be impactful. And again, if you want to be on this frequency and fly with us, UOUSummit.com. Go there right now. We appreciate y'all. Live audience from Mexico, give it up for yourselves. Y'all were amazing. And as we always say, we out of here. We love you. We'll see you next week.
I want you to focus on here right now. Don't you worry about when you get home. You make this, you concentrate on this opportunity. You don't worry about tomorrow. You concentrate on this opportunity with all your might, with all your soul.
Thank you so much for rocking with us as always, right? We don't take it lightly, guys. And we hope that we've provided transformation and not just information. We want you to become the best version of yourself, right? Make sure you check out the show notes to access all the important links and get your product discounts. Now, one favor we're asking of you, do us this favor. Make sure you subscribe and leave us a review on Apple Podcasts. We want to know your feedback and how we can serve you better. And if there's anyone that you think could benefit from listening to this show, please, I'm begging you, please share it with them. And remember, as E always says, if you want to succeed as bad as you want to breathe, then you'll be successful.